Okay, I've started recording just for the sake, so I'm gonna do a little intro. Hello, welcome to a live reaction Key Radio Live. I'm Lucci. I'm here with Mitsuna, who's a special guest joining us, who's gonna interpret for us. And yeah, we're very excited about what's going on. I am not going to edit this episode. I'm just going to post it raw. So if I say a curse word, sorry. There you go. I'm just like looking at chat. Cortez says, do some of you know Japanese here? I'm studying at the moment, but I'm not that good now. There are quite a few people in Keyverse who are studying it, but very few who are fluent. Mitsuna is probably our most fluent because you work in for a Japanese company, isn't that right?
Yeah, I mean, I used to live there and I was tutored the language from really young, so it's I got the same education as like a Japanese kid, really.
Right, right. We have we also have a few.
Do you speak it with a British accent? No, no. No, I speak it like a native. It's normal. I think my tutor would have smacked me if I did that.
Oh, Utori is here. Hello, hello.
Hello.
That's very exciting. Utori's PFP right now is of the key visual we just got, and it's just like
so nice.
I'm also fluent, but like I'm slower. Yeah, Utori, our server owner, was the lead editor for the Angel Beats patch. And also Reflection Blue? Yes, also Reflection Blue. That's what I thought. I couldn't keep track of who did what for which Alka project because some of them have similar teams, but some people changed roles. 75% of Reflection Blue, and that's like a monster work. Oh, that's another thing we should talk about. Length. How long do we think this is going to be? The stream started. Okay, so we're gonna click over there. You can't actually see it on my Discord end, so on OBS, so I need to fix that real quick. To stay like that if he's up till 5 every day.
God knows.
Like,
I mean, a lot of people.
Nice hair.
A lot
I'm
of people in Japan, it's like really normal to get the chemicals straightening.
Oh, so got it. Yeah.
When I saw the live a few years ago,
I love this song so much. Like, I still just, I'm always like freaking out about how when they needed a a song for Torch to sing in Kaginato, they picked this one. And I'm like, you couldn't have picked anything better. Along with Screamy, about 1 hour.
On the side there where it says
Yeah, Cortez just said in Italy it's 11 a.m., which is pretty normal, but we have people get up at insane hours in Keyverse for these things, because, like, this is our, it's an English-speaking community, but we have people here from all over the world, which is just really, really exciting just to see Keys reach for stuff like this. So it's really nice. Zane says 5 a.m. here. It is 5 a.m. Here where I am as well. In the Southeast United States.
9:58 for me in the morning.
Not too bad.
Not bad.
But you had to take off work for this, didn't you?
I literally have, like, Chateau constantly sending me messages on the phone, like, can you do this, can you do that? And I'm just like,
Yeah, no. Oh, rip.
No, I'm not doing it.
Insane episode.
I took off for this. Hello,
I mean,
Tori.
I tried, but Japanese bosses don't let you get off that easy.
Yeah.
Oh.
All right, Utori's all the way up anyway, so we're good.
Yeah, that typically happens.
Oh, never mind, it didn't start.
I have to be...
I thought it did, too, for a second.
I have to be lit quiet. Let me see if I can grab Platy.
To jump in, yeah.
Long day for them, though.
By the way, if the stream stutters on the Discord end, you can watch that on YouTube and just mute it for yourself, and just listen to the commentary from us. I'm just streaming it for the people where Visual Arts is blocked in their country, and also for OBS, because I am recording this.
They block it in some places?
Yes.
Wow.
I think Australia, if I remember correctly, blocks Visual Arts.
Don't believe.
I think it's certain countries where, like,
I can see it in Australia.
R18. I think it's like because Key technically does R18 works, like,
or has in the past, at the very least.
Certain countries that ban pornographic content gets blocked. Here we go.
あ、です。ルカン・カレリンの、ちょっと今回もまた、あの、VA
cafe から送りしてますけど、あの配信環境や
Okay, so they're filming from VA Cafe, which is the name of their little studio space they have here.
大丈夫そう?
It's so adorable.
始めていきます。
はい。Look at all that merch that I want.
They're gonna start.
チャンネル
TOP 一挙放送
他の問い合わせ I think he's tired because he's got no idea what he's doing and said what was this called again and he's saying that this is
key
channel
Bro's the lead producer
予定を変更してこうで TOP 一挙放送すると
President of the company now
多分1時間尺が持ってしまうという
はい、結構あの途中でぶつ切りしてしまって不安になってたけど
いや本当はねちょっとまあまたおおあの待っていただいてる間にね楽しんでもらおうというのでじゃあまたちょっとね
Yeah, they put all the opening songs on so that people could have something fun to watch whilst waiting
ちょっと
調整するかな今のうちに
They're gonna change their mics I think because it's the sounds a bit off Okay, they're gonna fix the microphones.
Fantastic music choice.
Completely.
They're gonna start with introductions. This is the announcement stream to the new Full Chorus Key game. This is the producer, Okano Toya, who is also now the director of visual arts.
まあやっぱりね、サンオポケから
流れてた。 Yeah, he's gonna stick with the producer name, he's saying.
ディレクターのカイです。で、
I'm the director, Kai.
前回のね、あのちょっと放送と。
He's like the assistant, he's saying.
More like the goat.
他の P だったらまあ普通でいいかと思ったんだけど。
And they're calling Okano Toya Okano P because he is like used as producer because he's produced this. It's like an idol game kind of phrase.
That sounds so cute.
It is. It's very
cute.
But he's saying everything will be fine as long as Okano's here, as long as he's going to be the producer.
Kai does good work, anyways.And again, it might not get delayed whenever Baba's not behind the decisions.
Okay, so they're going off on a tangent about the stress that they've been having and that they're trying to get over it by eating nice things recently. I think they've been pretty busy.
I want to give them hugs.
And talking about how they've put on weight, so because they keep eating stuff to deal with their stress, they're saying that there's like some people that don't seem to put on weight and others that do.
Oh no. It's never a good thing. Plenty. I stress eat too. It's okay.
Plenty says I'm never mind. I'll read chat later.
And they've received a lot of comments and questions from Twitter. And they're going to answer all of those for you. What is a full price?
It's been a while.
フルプライスって何ぞやというあこれはねちょっと
令和のユーザーの yeah, the question is,
what is a full price? 化粧芸の基本的
な and they're saying that this is most likely a question from a user who is from the Neowa era which is like a modern day user who maybe hasn't touched these kinds of games before This is the kind of title that is usually sold in a package for 8,800 yen. It's a full game. For example, Canon Air, Clannad, Little Busters. These are full price games.This is like all the serious games. Yeah, and the amount of content inside is insane. Is what he's saying. And there's lots of mini games. There's loads of different endings. There's different options to choose in each route.
I cannot wait to see the mini games.
Yes, those are always the best part.
And we also have a kinetic novel genre. And when we announce a new game, we have to actually say if it's going to be a kinetic novel or full price because we have these different naming choices, the genre names.
It makes me so excited that there's new enough Key fans that they had to define what a full price work is.
Same.
But yeah, this is what we call a full price. 8,800 yen. It's a bit expensive, but the inside of the game is well worth it, and there's lots of content that can be played for many hours.
I'm gonna use it as the stinger for the our like recap episode. It's just like so perfect. Yeah, it's so perfect.
Oh, the catch copy here is that promises are blowing in the wind.
Oh, I've honestly have not taken the time to actually read what it was saying. I've just been like, ooh, art.
約束は風の中に. And then also, I need to mention, staff, Kimishima Al is on this game. It's insane. I'm so happy about that.
I'm so happy.
Okay, so that was the teaser. And also over here, we have the teaser
video.
And Kai said he never realized it was there. He's only just noticed it. And Kai was in Osaka doing work right up until the last minute, so he's quite tired and did not notice the art behind.
He's cooking.
Yeah, he wasn't sure if he was even gonna come. He was like, do I still have to go? He was working to the last second. This is the new key full price game, Anemoi.
Also interesting that it's another, like... what type of
key visual? And she's standing in front of a windmill. But what is she doing?
Blowing on a leaf.
Yeah, so they're making a joke about summer pockets because the first thing that happens in the game is that he says, Sashizume Orewa. And they're saying, oh, she's not doing what Heidi did in a way. But yeah, she's playing a grass whistle. And they're going to start talking about what kind of game this is going to be.
Yes.
The kind of environment, the feel, that's what they're going to discuss.
This is one of my favorite pieces of teaser visuals, honestly. Like, it's so
okay,
good.
So like, modern day people are tired? That's like, it's like the people being exhausted. Like, this is the theme of the game, apparently.
Ooh.
Like, the modern day era of people being exhausted with their lives. And they go to a place where they can try and heal. And I don't know, I guess heal themselves, feel more relaxed, which is obviously this area that's in the teaser.
I'm already sold.
Yeah, it's like this kind of countryside setting where time doesn't really seem to pass, and this is where people go are exhausted with their lives.
Summer pockets, but not.
And this place will take away, the game itself will take away kind of your daily stress, your exhaustion.
And make
yeah, so Summer Pockets had this theme of like your summer holiday. But and also there's like a barley field in the it's this kind of soft and relaxing field compared to that. There might be horses and things in this area. And yeah, the theme is wind, so they're really expressing that with the art here.
Especially with the name Anemoi.
Yeah.
For those who don't know, that's a reference to a Greek god of the wind.
They're saying it's kind of like a harvest type of game, like farm kind of game, like this kind of this theme of farm and harvest.
Yeah.
So there's only two harvest seasons, spring and fall. So I'm really hoping it's fall.
But with the theme wind, there's a lot of things that they could cover. It's a very broad term.
Yeah.
It's not just a slow life. It's like there's something more behind this visual. There's more going on.
Always has been.
Yeah, they're talking about how there might be farms and stuff working. But this is the key wind game. And also the catch copy is that promises are blowing in the wind, so that holds some meaning as well. Farmer Saito.
Oh, I'd love to see a farmer Saito. That'd be funny.
Just Kyosuke all grown up.
Oh, like... so when they first made this catch copy of promises blowing in the wind, everyone kind of went, oh, and they all kind of felt that this was the right catch slogan to give to the game. It's this slow life, kind of daily life. But there's also like something very complicated going on. There's like some confusion happening behind the scenes. So there's a little bit more than what you see on the surface.
That's key magic.
The character, this girl in the... They're going to talk about this girl and the user.
I need a name.
Oh, there's a visual coming. But it's just the like draft in a way. The first reveal of this visual. Oh, Anemoi Heroin Shoukai. So this is Sonichi. Okay, so this is the first sort of reveal. Spika-chan. Her name's Spika.
Spika.
Her name is Spika. I'm guessing it's spelled like this in English.
Yeah, I would assume it's that, unless otherwise.
She's got kind of golden, silvery, a silvery metallic-y hair.
Oh my word, she is so adorable.
She's beautiful.
And what kind of personality she has.
It's Lilac hair.
She's like the cool kind of, I guess kind of like Shirohai in a way. She's like quiet and... Yeah, she's a little bit bitter towards people. Like, she's a bit cold.
Interesting. There's a lot you can do with that still. Like, I don't think Shirohai was the full explanation of that character type.
Yeah, they weren't too sure whether they should go with this or not, but same thing. Shiro has also this kind of character where she's a little bit cold towards people that you don't really know.
Interesting.
But we also thought that we need to really give her some different things compared to Shiro, her like different personality traits.
Okay, good. So, the fact that they were aware of that.
Yeah, this was allowed, even though it was a little bit similar to Shiroha.
The sky.
Main hero, heroine, Spika-chan. I'm very excited to see what kind of story this will be. Does this girl have an actual tail? Is the question.
I've been wondering.
The elephant in the room.
So
something's telling me real.
Yes.
Oh, it's not real, this is just attached to her clothes.
I'm sad.
There is a reason behind it, but this is just attached to her clothing.
It better not be trauma related.
あ、そうですね。これじゃあ、
こThat is very upset right now that it's not real.
こう制服のようにちょっと着てるわけ
じゃない。Which I just think is funny.
She's wearing this kind of cape and and
はいはい、あーフードがちょっとわかりにくい。はいはい、ちょっとわかりにくいです
けど。You can't really see it from here, but there is a hood there.
ちょっとそういう、まあまあ、辛辣だけども、実は。
You can see it in the teaser image.
かわいいものか。
I love her clothing design.
She's very cool. ドリスとこう心を会話するような、そういう女の子なのかもしれない。
She's got this kind of, she might be the kind of character that can communicate with animals. She is this kind of, this kind of.
Oh, okay.
They're
not being too
specific. I think they're just throwing these out there. It's like, it might be this. They don't want to tell us.
Yeah, you're trying to compensate for the disappointing reality it is not real.
But that is the main heroine, Pika-chan. We're going to answer a different question now. So about the volume of the game content, in comparison, if you were going to call Summer Pocket's Reflection Blue as a one in terms of...
Chipotle's Carne Asada is back.
Thank you, Ed.
It's our most tender...
Yeah, it's saying that if the...
grilled and seasoned with cumin, oregano, and coriander.
A one in
finished
terms
with fresh
of, like,
lime and
anchovy
cilantro.
What number on the
Carne
scale
asada.
Would you call anime?
This is our best steak ever.
I've got no idea what the answer is because it got turned into Chipotle.
Yeah.Summer Pocket RB と比べるというのはあのちょっと贅沢だよ。
Summer Pocket
Reflection Blue. Apparently, if they're going to compare it to Summer Pocket's Reflection Blue, it's a bit like too luxurious. I can't say that word. Luxurious to compare it. Like there's so much content.
Yeah, I was about to say RB is the longest keyword we've
got. And RB, of course, is like extra. It was like the fanness. I don't know if they can.
It's also the longest thing we've gotten from Key, line-wise.
Yeah, so RB is like two full-price games in one in a way, so that they can't really compare it, they're saying.
と RB の間ぐらいには行くかなというところですね。
まあここからね、何かこう、あの、まあ、と言ってますが、と言うてますが、言うてますが、果たして。
そうそう、こっち、あの、
いや多分
増えるんだ。
減ることは多分ない。
減ることはない。
おそらくね。それでね。
But yeah, they're not going to make. They're trying to fill in as much as possible, but they're not going to shorten it. Like they're trying not to cut as much as possible. 最初
ね、このくらいの大きさで作ろうって言ったのが、気がついたら今度このあたりですか。こう転がしていくうちに、
ちょっとピーが、ピーが目を引かしてる。
まあまあでもね、はい。まあでも大体無印と RB の
間ぐらい。
間ぐらい。
So it's kind of like in between, just like a zero, and then top of it's RB being a one. So it's like in between that amount of content. So normal full price, I'd say.
So about base Little Busters, we could probably expect base Little
Busters. How many heroines are there going to be this time?
This will help answer that as well.
ぶっ込んできたな。
まあ先ほどね説明したようにフルプライスというからには、
So because it's a full price game.There's going to be around five heroines.
Awesome.
Some pockets was originally four, but they are looking at five heroines.
今日まあ、Perfect. やっぱこういう場なので、やっぱ持ってきてはいるんですよ。
Oh, they actually they've brought some drafts. Wait, Kimishima. Oh, I'm watching the stream on YouTube. It's already there. Oh my god.
Sorry.
This is Eiko-chan.
Adorable.
Wait, they called her the same as that Final Fantasy IX character.
This is Eiko-chan.
もうなんかこうすごい可愛い笑顔で、はい、もうこちらの
段階
で、
君様、oh man,
ゴーグルっぽいのをちょっと掴んで、
This is her character.
I'm so happy that she's in this game. She, wait, she's wearing like a pretty big heroine then, because she's the second one to be shown.
Oh my god.
She's very bright and happy and kind. That's her personality.
Man pig core.
I was literally thinking the same thing, Tori.
She's her age is actually A bit older. Oh, sorry, younger. Not... She's younger. Compared to the
rest. 今回ちょっとやっぱ田舎だけに動物っぽい子が多いのかもしれませんね。
結構天真爛漫で。
They're in the countryside. There's all these kind of animal-like girls. Yeah, she's a bit younger.
可愛い。
確かに。そうですね。ちなみにこれ。
And very cute.
でかい画像もあるんですか。ちょっともう。
Oh, and there's a big image as well coming.The full illustration.
Her whole art is so
illustration.
振ってきてる感。
確かにね。 ちょっとこうね、やっぱこの子も
風をはらんでおります。And the wind, the wind you can breathe.
Tell that there's a lot of wind from the hair.
Yeah, so if, when they're designing each character and getting these illustrations out, the same thing was with Stikal as well, but they really want you to see the wind, so there's a lot of hair blowing and skirts blowing, and this kind of falling position that they've been drawn in. Oh, but they're not actually animals, so don't be confused. And they kind of...They fall from a lot of places. I don't know. There's a lot of kind of animal type girls falling from places. Yeah, I think there's a lot of these poses of falling.
Biko-chan.
Sono-san-ko-chan. The third girl.
Is that Fumiya?
This is Fumiya's girl.
And this is
like
the
beautiful girl, the more elegant girl.
I'm guessing dark hair for her.
And she has this very like calm and elegant eye shape.
I love Fumiya's art.
She's a little bit kind of like a devilish character in a way.Very cute, but also quite elegant and a little bit not cold necessarily, but not evil. But I hope you understand what I'm saying. It's like, she's a little bit
frankish.
Yeah, that's the word, fiendish. Thank you. This is the full illest.
God, the stream is so grainy.
So, yeah,
I can't see it.
This is also like a falling pose. Oh, she's got garter belts.
Ooh.
Yeah, they're saying she's more like this kind of. Yeah, a little bit more of the older, mature, slightly more sexualized, probably, when it comes to the art.
ちょっと小悪魔っぽいなって見た目はあります
ね。Yeah, she's like a little devil.
自分にすごく自信を持っている女の子で。
If you're, yeah, if you're watching on the Discord stream, the quality is going to be significantly lower than if you're watching on YouTube. The Discord stream is mostly for the recording and for those who, where visual arts is blocked in your country.
Yeah, she kind of messes around the main character, the protagonist. She'll mess with him.
Kurigaya core.
She's that kind of personality. And she's also a bit selfish and likes to mess with other people and make them do what she wants them to do.
I know which round I'm reading first.
We can fix her.
Oh my god, wishless.
I can make her worse.
She's very pretty, but also on the inside, she's not exactly the nicest person. But yeah,
Lani,
the skirt is very short and it's like very borderline. How in designing, they were like, how far can we go with this? We don't want it to be too erotic, but yeah, they went as far as they could without pushing it.
Oh, that is also adorable. I love the hat.
They've brought four characters here, but I believe there is actually five, considering what they said earlier. So. This is Yunon's character. Sorry, I just really like the hat.
Yes, I'm a few minutes ahead.
Nagayama Yunon's character. That's very cool. This is like the really hard worker. She's not the best at what she does, but she's really trying her best.
Mikor.
And she's got this big hat. And there's feathers on the hat. That's the feathers there on the side of the hat.
Loving the variety here.
And they also have the full illustration from Nagayama Yuno, which is this one. She's kind of jumping up a little bit. She's like in the air a little bit. And there's some letters and envelopes flying out. So she might be some kind of like post girl. Yeah, there's lots of letters and envelopes flying around. Yes, this is her kind of part-time job or work. This is what she does. Post. Yeah, she's kind of like a postman. And yes, she's the type, she's delivering other people's feelings to the recipient. She's delivering feelings, is the idea of this character.
Oh, that is so key.
I love her
that so much.
I love all of
them. Yeah, she really tries her best, and she's like, I'm going to deliver everyone's feelings to them. Like, this is her kind of saying. Even though she's not necessarily the best at it, she's dropping the obvious.
Last art.
That's the fourth member, and there is a fifth coming. Is this the
end? Oh, I love this.
I guarantee there is a fifth. There is five heroines earlier. And yeah, of course, I've brought the fifth one. This is the fifth girl. Oh my god. Also, earlier I think I misheard the character's name is Eiko, but it turns out they're lettering them. So we know none of the names except for Spikar, so don't get confused. The only character we know the name of is Spikar-chan. Earlier, Eiko-chan, Biko-chan, like, they're just naming them as letters. As like, for now, because we can't reveal the names. This is also another girl. She's got like this mature side, but also a really childish side. She's for some reason got both sides to her. It's a little bit strange.
Ooh, I love this. This is my favorite design.
So she's kind of like the younger character, but then also she's got this motherly side as well.
She's
got both sides of that in her somehow.
Look at that art, Platy. Look at that art.
This is very pretty.
Same, Platy, same.
Yeah, they really like behind the knees. They're really focusing on like behind the knee there, that nice part of the leg. And yeah, she's wearing tights apparently, so if, when we see her, she will be in tights in color.
Bless.
And this is the focus, is her legs, really. This is the
defining character trait.
I'm not sure.
She looks the tallest.
She's very stylish compared to the rest. It's like a stylish.
Ooh, I love style.
But apparently she's got a childish side. Yeah, she's got a very nice body. Supposedly. I'm just copying what they're saying.
Allegedly.
It's just funny watching them point out things like behind the knees.
It's like back to their roots here.
Now, this is as much as we'll show.
More than we thought.
We still have some other characters as well that we can't show yet.
Yeah, I mean, they need a supporting cast.
There's the protagonist, there's the heroines, but there's also sub characters as well. So, obviously, there's some sub characters that they won't be able to show today.
Yeah, we'll have a lot to talk about.
Like, the adult characters and those kinds will also be in the game. Yes. They are saying they have prepared some adult characters. Like how in some pockets there was like Kyoko-san. Oh, is the protagonist a boy? Yes, is the answer. Of course he is the answer. It's a Reiai Adventure, which is like the kind of, there's romance involved. So yes, they have chosen to have a male protagonist, which is what they want to say. Who posted the Charlie GIF?
Yeah, baby!
GIF and character. Sorry, I say GIF and not GIF, don't say GIF. Oh, they're gonna show the staff. Great, we could talk about Kimishima Ao now.
Yay!
Yeah.
はい、では、スタッフの方を改めてご紹介させ
ていただきます。長、文雄、長山優の君島青 on the characters and art。
長山優乃さん。
君島青 actually works for visual arts on Einstein より愛を込めて、which is an amazing game. Her art is fantastic. I never thought she would be in Key. So everyone, please follow her Twitter. She's amazing. She's honestly so good.
I'm definitely.
Scenario is Kai, 君島優、Hasama、Sayuki Shun, and the music is Orito Shinji. Director is Kai, who is sat right here, and the producer is Okano Toya, who is also sat right here.
Beautiful.
ディレクターを担当したというのは、キーファンには馴染みあるかもしれません。はい、
ロメオさんとともに、
Yeah, they're saying that people who will recognize these scenario writers.
彼は、
It's the summer pocket staff.
ということで、はい、そう言うなら、見せてもらおうかと。
最初は、
And Kai really was like, I really want to write this game.
AD で入ってもらって、アサインさせたんだけども、
Always a good sign when he really wants to write something.
Someone asking for Kimishima, oh, it's Twitter, I'll send it to
you.
Everyone followed because she is like one of. She had her first exhibition this year, but she's fantastic. I can't believe she's in Key. I never imagined this. Yeah, this is Kai's vision. He really wanted to write this game. He went into it with the concept in his head.
Oh, I'm. That means.
Oh, sorry, I accidentally put the FX thing. One second.
That means we're getting like.That's my word. That man, we're getting Kai like full on, just like
five level. Let me know if that doesn't work. I'll send it again. But yeah, this is the stuff. Sound team Orito Shinji, and there is more others. There's other staff as well, just like with the other games. But this is the lead producer, which is Orito Shinji. He's the music producer.
Bring the Lunaria people on for some tracks, please.
直前まで、はい、おじさんとこの曲のさあというのをずっとやってて、はい、でさらにさらにじゃないね、で、はい、ディレクターは僕です、はい、
and Kai 先生が、
はい、Director is myself, Kai, and producer is Okano Toya. Ten Kumo Genki, as we now know.
というタイトルがあって、それをやっぱ超えるものを作りたいっていう。
And they really want to make a work that takes it's better than Summer Pockets. They're really trying to aim higher than Summer Pockets and make a game that does better than that, like is more impactful than that one.
Ambitious.
So they're going to show another comment. There was a lot of changes recently at Visual Arts and the way the team.Oh, it's a comment from Nava. Okay, sorry, I didn't read that bit. Yeah, there's a lot of changes recently at Visual Arts, and the way they work and their staffing has changed quite a bit too. But they're really hoping that they can, they're really working hard every day to make a game that all of us can enjoy and play. So they're working hard every day on Anemoi, and they hope that we look forward to more information on it. This is from Naga, who is, of course, the main artist. Yeah, so every day they are working really hard on it.
まあ割とね、カイさんと長さんは結構ね、意見をね、戦わせることもね、会議では多いですけど、まあその分ね、
やっぱね、長さんはね、はい、こう、けなし8褒め2ぐらいかな。その褒め2が妙にこう嬉しい褒め方をしてくれるんですね。
まあ仕事に厳しいと。
そうです。
はい。はいはい
It's a nice comment to receive from Naga. They're happy to hear it. This is from Fumiyun, who is also one of the artists on this game. She has worked on Summer Pocket and Lunaria, but this is her first time working right from like the very beginning of a full price game. This is very new to her because previously, when she joined Summer Pocket, she was doing like sub characters. So she's bringing out lots of different ideas, and it's very fun for her to do. It's very refreshing, and she's.Going to work really hard on Anemoi.
I'm so happy for her.
Same.
I've always said give her a full price VM.
With Lunaria and Summer Pocket, it was like after the concept had already been made that she joined in, but this is her first time like really being there right from the beginning when there's nothing and like helping out with the concept.
I'm so happy for her.
Yeah, so she's doing quite a big job. This is the design of the uniform. This is the base design. So each character, she revealed the other day in her blog that each character has a different variant of this uniform. So we're going to see some different versions of this kind of uniform.
This is really awesome one. Best key uniform right there, like no question that.
Yeah.
They apparently this was so difficult to make. They worked on this for months and months. They had to keep sending it back. Naga then reworked it for me and then took it back and reworked it. Then they sent it to them. It was insane. Like, they designed this before even starting the characters. So this is like their huge sort of project. This is like half the game itself. They spent so much on this. Yeah.
Like Little Busters, who best uniform right there.
Yeah, this is like a really meaningful design to them. They wanted to have like this. They wanted like this kind of blue design to go with it. But I hope they share all of the different drafts they had for this. I'd love to see the change.
That'll probably be in the art book.
It really took a long time. And each character has its own like version of it. They're saying there's like their personality really shows up in each character's uniform. He's trying to look for his illustration. I can't find it.
I'll take wearing a uniform all the time if that's the uniform. Like, that's nice.
To continue, we've got a comment from Nagayama Yuno, who obviously like drew Tsumugi, and she's a good I'm very happy to be working on the Genga team, which is like character design and also some base coloring. My character is someone who I feel like it's going to be really loved for all of her charms. I really hope that I can deliver you a character that you all really love, and I'll work really hard in order to do that. No, she didn't say Tsumugi in the comment. I'm just saying that this is who this is in case people didn't recognize the name. But yeah, this is also her second time doing actual Genga team, so this is really cool.
A lot of new artists.
Kimishima Ao, who I'm freaking out about. I have been very gladly accepted into the Genga team of Anemoi, the new title from me. I'm Kimishima Ao. I'm really moved by the beautiful teaser visual and the really lovely atmosphere that this concept is giving off. So I'm really working hard on this game. Please look forward to more information. Kimishima Ao is like, I can't believe it. I was literally talking about her the other day and how relevant she was to like Key fan art back in the day, and like a week later she's in Key.
This is like an all-star cast.
Oh, she's also working on sub-characters apparently, so that's exciting.
Amazing.
So some of the characters that you'll meet on your way within the game. And even within the company, Kimishima Al's characters are like super popular right now. They all really like her design. Like, it's like, they feel almost like the protagonist like stole her from them. It's like, we want this character for ourselves. They really like her character designs, both her heroine and her sub-character.
From
Nijima Yu, who is the writer.
Made it the most underrated rounds.
I am always having pizza toast during my lunch break, and I'm writing Anemoi in the morning. That's the kind of game this is. I'm really being like healed by these really lovely cute heroines and characters. Oh, I was writing. He's saying it's kind of, this is what I'm doing in my day. I'm having pizza toast. I'm writing Anemoi every morning and having pizza toast for lunch. It's this kind of game. That's what he's saying. Pizza writing? I don't know.
I love him.
He's such a goofball.
Right?
One of the most underrated routes in Summer Pockets, too.
Yeah, completely.
So Mijima was really involved right from the start when they were really making this concept in the first place from zero.
Nice.
Obligatory read Hatsuyuki Sakura.
Yes.
Yeah, they're really looking forward to you for you to read his work. And also like finding out why things are a certain way in the game. Like, he's really good at writing. Okay, next from Hasama. I'm the writer Hasama. Yeah, so he's really trying to push himself with this game, do things that are really challenging him. So every day at the moment, he's like kind of living with half, really enjoying his work, and then half being really anxious about it. But he's doing his best to kind of balance those two out and keep working. I'll work really hard. So please, everyone, I really hope that you can be excited for this game.
I'm already so excited.
Same.
It's interesting that he's kind of the only one so far that's really said that he's like challenging, really challenging himself. It's just like, he's really challenging himself with this game. And he's half anxious and half excited. Yes, Nijima Yu is one of the writers on Hatsuyuki Sakura, which is this screenshot posted in the chat just now. I said, text is safe, Shu. Okay, I got it.
I should have.
I'm obsessed.
Was get any Google Pixel 8 phone starting at $10 a month at AT&T. No trading required.
The setup of the end, but he never thought that he would be allowed to work on a full price game like and he was always this fan of Key that was always chasing Key games and really enjoying Key games. So for him to work on a game really means a lot to him. And as a writer, he is going to put his everything into making a game that everyone can enjoy.
I'm excited. He's got like three credits on
me. Did anyone miss what I said because of the commercial? I can reread it. But he's basically saying that he was the director in Demon Slayer. And then he didn't ever think that one day he would have a full price game like this. This really means a lot to him because he was a Key fan back in the day. The whole reason he writes is because of Key, so it's like, this it means a lot to him.
I'm very happy about that because he had very few credits.
And also, I am a very young writer. He's in fact the youngest out of everyone, but regardless, he's going to put his all into it to make up for that.
For context as to how young, he is only got three credits.
He's saying this is our first new full game since Summer Pockets, which was now around 5 years ago. So he's really happy that he can now finally announce it. So from around approximately 2 years ago, they've really been having loads of meetings, loads of sort of working together on this game for 2 years straight now. So they're really looking forward to the day that everyone can play this game. And so that day comes a little bit sooner, they're all really working very hard to make sure it's completed on time. Yeah, he's really good at kind of turning people's sort of writing and what they want to express into then the music that goes with it. And he's very much got this leadership role of, I want this to be expressed with this instrument, or I want this kind of environment or atmosphere to be expressed in this way. So he's really working hard on that, making sure that the writing is expressed well. Oh, they're kind of joking that they're going to play like this 45-minute movie. they've got a little bit of a problem right now, so they're just gonna wait. But they were joking just now that we'll play you like a 45-minute movie to wait, but they're not gonna do that, obviously.
All right, that's
just a little bit of a mishap, but
That's a good place to like recap our thoughts.
Make sure we're caught up,
and then also recap your thoughts.
Yeah, there was just a little bit of like noise in the background from the microphone, apparently. So.
Yeah,
I just want to fix it. Apparently, I didn't hear it myself. But.
I'm super looking forward. I'm very glad that the assistant director for Stella is on this, because the last problem that Stella had was like the only issue I had with Stella was more like Tanaka's decisions with where he was going. All respect to him, but just like not my type of story. But the direction was solid, like with the way it was put together. So I'm actually kind of glad that they're giving him a role, especially because he only had, this is his third credit on any visual novel, so...
Yeah, and for him to be, like, on this, like he was saying, he just can't believe that he's on the actual writing team from the get-go for a full-price game. That's really nice. And I love that Kia very open to working with, like, less experienced people and also younger people. I know I say young, it's, like, Japanese standards of young. But, yeah, for younger people... I mean, recently they hired an absolute crap ton of inexperienced writers. They were like, even if you've never, like, been published before, or you love to write and you have some work that you want to show us, like, and they were hiring, like, you cannot believe. The Japanese work websites were just full of visual arts adverts for inexperienced writers, which is really... Goko-chan, my beloved. Oh, Ii-chan. So the name isn't actually Eiko-chan. It was just like, A is like the letter A. It was just like they called her girl A, girl B, girl C, girl D. And then for some reason they called girl E, girl 5, which is Goko-chan. Anyway, yeah, they hired a lot of inexperienced writers and they were like really pushing. I think ever since Tenku no Genki is on the, he's now like the director of visual arts. He's really pushing to have these young writers because that's how he got into the company. He was... only in his 20s, I mean, he very, very young. And then even when he first joined, Baba was saying, I want you to be the next director. So for him to then like achieve that, I think he really wants to do the same for others and have youngsters come in who haven't really written much before, but they can like nurture them. That's what their new goal is, like to nurture new talent. That's what they were saying in the last stream. So it's nice to see that actually kind of being cultivated here. Okay, they are back and they are like doing
what are they doing? They're doing good juju. That's what they're doing.
Just they're apologizing for the sound.
Right.
They are back. And I think it's
fixed.
Okay, they're going to start again.
Yeah,
this is quite a new studio for them, so there's a lot of things they have to kind of get used to, and there's sometimes these issues that kind of happen during streams. But...
Okay,
this was when they were
just
in the middle of showing
the
staff, and they are going to now show a comment from Twitter. Will Maeda Jun be in this game in any form whatsoever?
Maeda Jun 氏は何らかの形で関わっていますか？これ、Twitter でもかなり多かった。
This was a very popular question on Twitter, apparently.
Understandable.
Even with Summer Pockets, he was involved with songs
and such.
So he was in the actual concept meeting. And he is kind of involved. He is doing it together with them. Yeah, they made like this concept sheet. And documents in and around the third time he looked at it and he was like, okay, this sounds pretty good, so he's kind of giving his input there. Like the concept isn't him, but he's like looking at it and saying, oh, this is good, this is bad,
advisory role kind of.
That's and, like, sort of like what Hisaya was on Cry Machina.
Yes, Satori, I think that sounds about right.
And also, it will just kind of involve how much work they've got left to go, whether he's more involved or not. But yeah, it's basically like giving his blessing. I mean, he's very busy with Seven Burns Road, so
yeah,
it's just how much he can fit in. But yeah, he has been in the concept meetings and present. So in your previous anime, a certain anime, Ugu was a popular phrase. It's still popular even now. Like, people still won't shut up about it on Twitter. It like constantly gets in the trends and stuff. So will there be, like, he's really wondering if there will be another character with this vocal tick, like this thing that they say. Will there be another character with this kind of phrase that they like to say, the catchphrase, like Ugu from Kenna? Or like Mugyu from Soul Pockets. That's Kai really likes Mugyu.
口癖までいくかどうかわからないけど、
口癖は like your vocal catchphrase
とか、まあ、はいはいはいはい、いるなというところですね。だからこれ狙いすぎると、はい、あざとくってちょっとこう敬遠されてしまうんで、はいはいはい、本当あの扱い方が難しい。
They don't want to like push it too much. They don't want to like make it and then have to cut it or something. But there might. There isn't like a proper full-on phrase like ugu or something, but there is something small there. It's not like too much. It's not going too hard where she says every single time. But they have made up this phrase, which hopefully will become like a popular phrase like the previous ones. Saraba Yukichi from Little Busters is another one that's all worth talking about. So they have kind of made, it doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be like Ugu. It might be like Little Busters where Kiyosuke's famous phrase is now used by all the pachinko people on Nihonko. But yeah, there might be a phrase that's going to become, like it's going to catch on. So you are currently in production. How much of the game is completed? What percentage of the game is currently completed? You can't talk about development in numbers, apparently. He doesn't really want to say it in numbers. It's a bit dangerous. Doesn't want to say anything. Characters are decided.And they are also obviously right now announcing it, so they are on time, is what they're saying. Yeah, they are already at the point where they can like really show the characters' traits and their charms and things like that. Personalities are down. Yeah, he's not sure what he wants to say here.
Well, you don't want to make unfulfillable promises.
The fact that they are able to announce right now really means that it is pretty much mostly it's on time, and there is quite a lot of time already. And they just want you to wait a little bit longer.
Yeah, I do hope it's a 2024, so that's the 25th anniversary work.
Yeah, so this is all that they can say about that.But it's definitely in good running that they can announce it right now, so they're on track.
詰めてきますけども、多分開発としてはここからが本当に頑張り時というかね。
Yeah, so right, from now is the time when the development team really give it their all, and they're really trying their best from here on. They've got a lot of work to do.I am wondering if there's going to be some kind of mini game type of thing, or this kind of way of different ways of playing within the game in this game as well, just like previous game. But yeah, kind of saying, yeah, it's a full price game, so that will exist. There will be different kind of like play styles and mini games within this game as well. We are making these.
Beautiful. We'll have something to have keepers compete with.
Mammon fight in some markets, this kind of thing. There will be something like that in the new game.
Let's go.
They're saying maybe, but yeah, they're saying that they're making it. They're just trying to be vague.
サマポケはやりすぎたかなというぐらいだけはするんだけれども。
He played Summer Pocket so much because of the Pokemon game. Yeah, he's saying like maybe I didn't put this in there because it's like too addictive. But yeah, they are making something. They quite like having something different to play within the actual game.
楽しめるような作品を。
だから当然これ結構前田から言われていたことで、まあ、前田のこだわりでもあるんだけど、うん、恋愛趣味じゃない、恋愛コメちゃんゲームと、ね、いう名前がついている限りは遊ばせなきゃいけない。
Yeah, because...Oh, so because it's called an AI adventure game, like the love adventure game, the fact that it says the word game for them, for Key, it really means that, well, it's a game. You should be able to play it, not just read it. So they like to add a mini game. That's their theory behind adding mini game.
Oh, cool.
Not a rhythm game, but that would be cool. But I don't know. But yeah, it's something you can play, like actually play like a game. He wanted to show more comments, but with the time and it's coming up to an hour, they're not really sure they can show anymore. And all of the development team are looking at Twitter and even getting their motivation from everyone's sort of excitement. Well, apparently there's like over 3 million views on the announcement tweet. So, yeah, they're really happy about that.
Yeah, the stat on it's like 3.5 million views. Like, it blew up on Twitter.
The views are like over 3 million at the moment, apparently.
はい、あ、そうです。ステラ、自分期待られてますから。はい、あ、そうです。ステラ、自分期待られてますね。あの、はい。はい、というわけですね。はい、じゃあちょっと本当にあっという間でしたけどもね。はい、ちょっとエンディングに行かせていただきたいと思います。そう、it was quite, it felt quite quick, but this is now the ending.
So for people who want to know more about the characters that they just showed earlier and also just the setting, what should I do is what you're saying. Yeah, this is exactly what I was saying before. So it will be in the rough note. I called it. So if you want more, buy the key set at FuyuFest and there will be the rough note, as there always is. So every year with a new key game, they always show the character drop and just announce the new characters in the rough note. It's like a booklet that is always made the year before a game comes out. So it'll be for whatever the next game is in the next year. So yeah, you can buy the key set and see more in there. Buy the key set at FuyuFest.
ちなみにこうなんかアネモイ以外もやっぱりたくさんキーセット
set is the set of the key calendar and the stickers that come with it, and there's usually like an arranged CD and things like that. They release it every year at Comic Market. It's been going on for years and years, but every year they will stick a rough note, which is like a book that comes with the set. It's always sold for 5,000 yen, but you buy it at Comic Market and it comes with a rough note that is for whatever the next game is. Oh, it will have like the drafts for the new characters and a little bit more information on the story. It's in black and white, you won't see any colors, but yeah, it will have each character's kind of draft page from the design. That's what a key set is. And FuyuFest is the online version that they made after COVID started, so you can buy it online as well. It will come with the calendar and the rough note and a few other things, usually a CD and such. Yes, it'll be December. That's what you should get if you want more information. That's usually where the new game characters get announced, to see like the line art show up in a stream. Like this is the first time we've seen that. But yeah, they're still going for their old-fashioned way of showing it in the rough note, which is nice. Yeah, they really wanted to like show how different this game will be from Summer Pocket. Yeah, they're really trying to like make a stark difference between these two games and produce something different that will aim above and beyond what they made.
そういうベースとしてはやっぱサマポケ的な、まあちょっとキー的な、キー的なものを本当にかくキープするというところですね。
But they still want to keep that key-like feel, like what Summer Pockets had. That really keep the key feel while still being very different.
The classic vibes.
But they want you to have like this new experience with the game.
それがそのプレイしてくれたユーザーさんのあの。
And they also want it to be like become a part of your life in a way after you've finished playing it, like part of your daily life where you kind of, you know, it leaves an impact on you. Kind of like the wind blowing into your life. They that's how the kind of experience they want to create with this game. And they're saying that they're going to try their best to do that.
They want us to be so impacted. We're thinking about this every day.
Look forward to our new game, anyway.
Oh, we will.
This is the... Oh, Steam, we're talking about a Steam, and he's saying, yes, we'll have a Steam. He's just confirming it now. It won't be for long. It won't be soon. It might be a long time, but he has just confirmed that there will be a Steam release in the future.
Amazing.
So that means this will be officially translated.
Yeah, yes. That was the comment. It was like from a foreign person, apparently. So.
Got it.
Yeah. Steam release.
Simultaneous release? No.
させていただいて、
no. just, 今後ね、just
ま、まずは、He's kind of putting it aside saying, look, it will happen, but just don't expect it like right now.
先の、展開にね、ぜひご期待いただきたいと思います。
はい。But yeah, please look forward to the follow, updates that will come in the following months, and thank you for watching.
Spend 500 hours reading it with the mouse over dictionary, I don't care. Worth it.
All right, that was it.
I hope I didn't like sound confusing. I know I. Yeah.
No, me too. No, like, thank awesome. You so much for doing this for us, for
That's
real.
Okay. That's okay. No, I just want to share it with everyone. It's really exciting. Kimishima, oh, I'm so excited. Her character looks so good. Hooray.
In terms of hype,
and also, yeah, the confirmation of the rough note was nice for me. I'm looking forward to the key set now.
Yeah, completely.
Sound cute. You are very welcome.
All right. Do either of you want to share any other thoughts before I stop recording?
I'm saving my thoughts for the episode, at least
okay,
live.
Yeah, you and I will, by the way, for those of you who are here in the live stream right now, Utori and probably Manpig and I are going to do a more, like, traditional Key Radio live episode talking about that, and it will be a double feature with the end of a first half of our season where we talk about One. We'll also bring up the One trial. It's going to be a huge Key Radio live tonight, which will be at 8 p.m. Eastern. Time Seven. Zone will it'll the events tab will adjust to your time zone.
Seven.
So check that out if you are want to hang out with us more about that. It's roughly 14 hours from now.
Lucci, 7, yes. Remember? We agreed to start early.
Oh, 7 p.m. Eastern. You're right. 13 hours from now. I forgot. Sorry.
Yeah, because we didn't want people who end up staying up late for Key Radio Live. Yeah, we didn't want people who were staying up late already for Key Radio Live to feel obligated to have to stay up late if they really wanted to hear the One episode.
Yeah.
Because... We basically just want to give ourselves time because we know we'll have a lot to say about Anemoi. This is where we typically get my like Herald predictions. Like these are the ones that like before I know anything about a work, I just put down a prediction
Me
and
too.
Like full chest.
So I'm
excited.
This- Yeah, me too. Let's use this time to see if we can get anything else out of Mitsuna
yes.
while she's here.
So, I definitely want to hear your thoughts, Mitsuna.
Do you have anything else to add?
Not really. I think just that we've got one name, which is Speaker. No surname there. Maybe she won't even have a surname, because that doesn't sound like a normal name. That sounds like some kind of fantasy name. So yeah, it's a star. So I'm wondering what kind of other names the characters will have. But yes, there's five main heroines, and Speaker-chan is the main one in the teaser visual. That's... just wanted to clarify that. Apart from that, that was really good. I think that was really nice. I like that they didn't go too much into the character drafts, and they've left some for the rough note as well. So yeah, anyone who's not sure what the key set is and they want to pick it up or they want to participate in Fuyu Fest, just I'm happy to explain anytime. So when they announce Fuyu Fest, probably next month, I'm happy to explain if anyone wants to buy a key set and they've never done it before.
Links will probably be available in hashtag merch room, so watch that channel.
Yes. Yeah. A little cool, interesting tidbit about the name Spica. It's a star name, but it is also known as the brightest star in the Virgo constellation.
Oh, nice.
My astronomy brain's coming out a little bit. And it is specifically known colloquially as Virgo's Ear of Grain. And what do we see during the art? Grain. They definitely have a very intentional naming. Grain is most often associated with harvest and with wind. And grain symbology, this is like a little preview for the episode. I'll go deeper into this because I predicted Summer Pockets based off of teaser visuals. But grain does have literary meaning in a lot of cases. It can literally mean being one that is able to flow with the passage of time. So typically grain is used to represent passage of time because it's constantly swaying and moving with the wind. but it also means that it can also be something where the character is struggling to accept something. It is often used during times of great trial and sadness. So it's got like a dual meaning, basically, of being both very fluid, but also struggling to accept how life is. Because Grain's ultimate purpose is to get cut down.
That is super relevant to what they were saying, because they were saying how it's like this place that you can go there and heal your stresses, but then also there's some complications happening that you can't see on the surface, and that time kind of doesn't feel like it's passing, but then there's things going on at the same time. That's really interesting. Thank you for that.
Yep. That's and really cool. And the ultimate final meaning of Grain is the birth of something new. So the fact that they were really focused on a star that is one where Grain is like what it's known for, because it's like the ear of Grain of Virgo, but also like the fact that they're using Grain in the visuals, it really does feel like he is trying to emphasize that this is the start of something new. We're doing something different, but it's also got a lot of the core themes of Ki wrapped up inside of it. So I'm very excited.
I'm so ready for this one. This I can just kind of feel this the has mission, the potential to be one of my favorites.
Find handmade gifts that won't blow your budget.
Like, yes.
I love everything they've
said about
this.
Whether you need something
this,
for the home chef in your life,
yes,
like serveware and footwear, for me, or like style pieces like rings, brain, clutches, and seasonal brain. Jackets for that trend-setting special someone,
I would
has
by
it
that.
For all budgets.
I'm
new Etsy?
Use
code JOLLY10 for 10% off your first purchase. Maximum discount value is $50. Expires December 31st, 2023. See terms at etsy.com/terms. Etsy has it.
And also, just I've been wanting to play it forever. This is my excuse. So
I will, at risk of saying too much of my opinions before the episode, I will leave off with one more thing. And it is, this is a very unique position Ki is in currently, because we are officially out of the woods of anniversary projects. So this is the first new project we've gotten, like, with, like, where we didn't know something was coming in a while, and I'm very excited to see what they've got. I'll repeat this on the episode, but like, this is the first time since that 20th anniversary announcement that we've gotten a work that is kind of out of the kind, just kind of like not on the pre, like not in the zeitgeist basically of like Ki fans' minds. Like this announcement sort of just came and we were like, whoa.
Yeah.
It's a very new, it's almost like the start of the next phase that Ki's got going, and I'm very excited for it.
Yeah, I mean, with all of the star shake up in the direction with and also just the fact that the team is becoming younger. I'm really excited.
I'm very, very excited. I think I won't talk too much about this on the episode, so I feel free to say this, but I think the direction to go with newer staff is only a positive thing whenever they're trying to cultivate younger writers, because that means, much like how with Summer Pocket staff, there was a lot of staff that either got like side routes on Ki games or hadn't even worked on a Ki game. And they created a very unique experience that both honored Ki's past, but also was very unique in its own right.
Future proofs the brand, basically.
It does, because having young writers is a very good way to get the company to continue to innovate in storytelling.
Yes, exactly.
And that's what makes me very excited. It's why, even if Stella was not my favorite work, I'm very excited to see the director of Stella doing a route, because that is an opportunity. He's a very young writer. I mean, like I said, this is his third credit on VNDB, so I'm very happy that Ki is putting a lot of stake in younger writers, because admittedly, there's only so much that, like, the Midas of the world and the Kais. Not saying that Kai's anywhere near quitting. We don't know that. Only Ki knows that. But, like, there's only so much that the Midas and the Kais and, like, these experienced writers can write before they feel like they're retreading around. So it's very good. I'm very glad that Ki's trying to cultivate a like basically like a community where writers can come to them and make stories that they're passionate about. I feel that that's a very important part of their direction. I'm very happy about that. It also makes every new keywork exciting because then we get to see who the new writer is on the staff. Because I assume their strategy is probably get people acclimated, and then like we have Kai, Nijima, Yu, and Hasuma, which are sort of like our three writers from Summer Pockets, and we have the one new person. And so it'll be very exciting to see who that new person is in like that up and coming list, basically.
Is this Sayuki's first time writing scenario?
Yes. He had only been assistant director and then special thanks before. He was special thanks on Loopers and assistant director on Stella. So this is his first time writing scenario. This is fresh. Like, this dude is very fresh on like writing Key, and I think that's actually that makes me the most excited.
Has he ever written anything in the DM sphere?
No, his only credits were visual arts. He has two credits: Loopers, Stella, and then he also has obviously Anemone. I don't know what his credits are outside of VN. I would assume he's probably got something. But either way,
this is the nice thing about the community. A lot of people are just writing to so many youngsters in there that have never worked on a key game before or any big work before, and the whole reason they even started out doing writing or music or even art is because of Key a lot of the time. So it's
just
really nice to see this.
Full of positivity. Like, it's so fun. Like, it was almost as fun as like actually playing those games for me.
It's incredibly inspiring to see. And then the other thing I would point out is, I know it makes a lot, cause like with Loopers, Lunaria, and Stella on like the part of the Key community, especially over here, who would rather Key never change and not like grow older with the fan base, like getting new people, they were nervous because, like, well, if Maida's not here, then what's the point? And I'm like, well, Key can be more than just Maida. I mean, it has
they
been for a while.
Been more than,
yeah.
They always have been more than just
there's a culture, there's this weird culture of Maida worship in the US that's very weird.
People pointing the finger at just one person when, like, a game is a lot of different people working together.
Right.
Yeah, so I'm glad that Key wasn't, like, worried about that whenever they were, you know, thinking about this and seeing fresh faces. For me, while initially my gut reaction is, ooh, I'm gonna be sad that one day we won't see many Maida works, they also deserve a break.
He's doing Heaven Burns Red right now. Like, he's
writing
so
he's nowhere
more than he ever has done. That is long,
and
that's not even on chapter 5.
Yeah, he's nowhere near quitting. I'm just like, the reality hit me that there might be a day where Key doesn't have like Maida in the credits at all. Like, because we've got all these new people, but that's exciting because then we can have the next, like, Kai, the next Maida, like,
and
the people.
He's been there for a very long time. He's been there since he had hair, I think.
Yeah.
Like, he's been there. Like a big company name, but it'd be like Nikkei thing written there, which is like inexperienced. You don't need experience. To see that on a job advert is so unusual. And just everything they write, from the fact that they've got like flexi time hours, that there's not really a lot of overtime, and they really support their staff. So much on these job adverts. I just thought, this is so great. And I mean, for me, the biggest indicator that they are a good employer is the graphicers, always. The graphicers are the ones that are kind of like, they do everything, but they don't really get credited, they don't get to do anything. People won't point at the art and think, oh yeah, this person colored this. Like, people tend to think that the person colored the whole thing. Or they'll add the base color, and that's everything else, and that is how they keep the art looking consistent with the company's brand style. Like, it's done, yeah. It's done in, they learn the style, and that's their job to keep the style.
It's why you can have
their graphicers haven't changed in decades, and they are still the same people, and they love working there, and they get to design goods and merchandise. So much of the merchandise is drawn by the graphicers and not actually the artists. So much is done by them. I mean, they've got literally the whole blog to themselves. Like, the fact that Key openly name their graphicers and really hype them up and say, look, this is UT, like, they appear on the streams, they get to announce stuff, they get to make goods, they get to actually be someone. And the fact they haven't changed jobs, because usually what happens is graphicers will change either into a character designer, like Pal Nugger did. That is what he was originally, and he changed, but he still does half the job as well. Just really interesting. That's the only company I've ever seen where they've got graphicers that stay graphicers and stay working there and actually get named. Sorry, that went on for really long, but it's just super interesting to me that visual arts are pretty much the only company you will see that has that. Find other graphicers and find them actually be openly called graphicers and be on the website and on the streams and everything. It just does not exist.
Yeah, I mean, there's a whole part of every single credit sequence that calls out the graphicers. Like, it's
the fact that they're just on like live streams. Even Yuji was on last year's live stream wearing a Dumbo hat, like, and he's like, hi, and now he got promoted to director, but he's still a graphicer, but they let him become a director. Like, that doesn't happen. It's so cool. I love that.
It's what makes Key stand out, and I'm very excited to, one, not just, I'm glad to see that Key is embracing both its classic writers and artists and people who've been with the company for a while, and new styles, because that is, it just makes every new work more exciting, like, in my opinion, because then it's like, I can't wait to see where this goes. And that's kind of where I'm at with Anamoy. I mean, I'm sold on it already, just based off of...
Yeah, just from everything we've heard, and also already we're seeing so much imagery and deeper meaning, even with the character's name. So yeah, very exciting.
I'm very excited. I think that this will be... I mean, obviously Keyverse will be hype about it no matter what, but I think this will be a very hype like work for a lot of like the visual novel sphere, because it's got like what made Summer Pockets like initially appealing, which is that small town setting, the escape from modernism, which seems to be a very big theme in modern Key works. But it also has the very unique aspect of, one, it's not on an island, but it's also like specifically a place where people go to escape. So, which is not what,
it's also relevant to, like, you know, a group of fans like us who are, you know, who have been with Key for a while and are getting older. I've been around 11 years. Mitsuna, I think, even longer than me.
I'd say 11, 12 years as well.
11, 12 years, around the same. Like, and there are people in our chat who have been with Key since, like, since the 2000s. Like, it's, you know... This is, like, something that's going to be relevant to, like, a lot of people and not just, like, younger folks, which is, I really appreciate that a lot. I can already tell thematically where it's going there.
Also, I would... with Heaven Burns Red, obviously this is the whole thing of visual arts at the moment, and why they had the whole staffing change. We discussed it before, but Heaven Burns Red earned them the most money they've ever earned in the whole history of the company, so they've got more budget on this. This is their first full-price game since having that money.
Also, their first full-price games since dropping their 18 plus brands.
Yep. Yeah.
So
I will say I always joke about being a newbie in the key space whenever, but then I think back and I realize 2017 was how long ago? 6 years ago? 6 years ago now? So not near as long as either Lucci or Mitsuna, but I've
pretty long though.
I mean,
the timing doesn't matter, it's just how much you
I think the point we're trying to make here is in fact exactly what you said, like this is going to be a relevant one no matter who you are.
I like that, if
there was a tagline I could add to this work that like just what it screams from everything we've seen, it is the key work for both the old fan and the new. It is, yeah. It feels like a marriage of everything Key has been building up to, because Summer Pockets was very clearly reminiscent of classic Key works in the sense that like it had a lot of staff that had either worked with visual arts or like ideas that you could recognize, like, I mean, the core concept was so close to Air that Ida was like, I don't want to write for this. Please don't make me write for this. So we have that, obviously, but then we also have the fact that with, like, these ideas, right? Summer Pockets was very classic feeling, but then we instantly got shakeups like Loopers, Lunaria, that felt very new, fresh ideas. And this feels like a mixture of both, where we've got like this classic theming of Key, like this theme of promises, which is actually a core theme of a lot of Key works. Like, I mean, we've got canon, which, you know, I don't think I need to elaborate on clan canon. But we also have things like, even in Air, there was like promises and subtext. There's just a lot of promises in Key. So the fact that this is the work of promises is very interesting. I'm very happy. And like I said, this just feels like a good mix of old and new. And I'm already resonating with this work a lot. Like, I've very rarely told this story in Keyverse because it matters very little to the context of Keyverse, but I got into Key and there was two pivotal moments like in me getting into Key, I would say. There was that like matter a lot to like my Key story, and one of them was the fact that from a like whenever I first watched Clannad, I resonated with it. Like I felt it like hit a core, basically, like from the first like minute whenever I watched the Clannad anime. Like it was like the scene on the hill with like the colors coming to life whenever Tomoya saw Nagisa, like that was worth the price of admission for me. Like it just hit me that deep. And I just kept watching. And then the only other time I truly felt that, like from just like a clip of things, was the original Summer Pockets reveal. Where I was like, I looked at it and went, wow, this truly will be something special. I knew Summer Pockets would be my new favorite.
Now you can listen or like watch the podcast I saw it. You love on YouTube.
And
on the YouTube music app.
I'm getting very similar feelings here in the sense where it's like, I don't want to go out on a limb and say it will be my new favorite because Summer Pockets means so much to me, but I'm getting the same resonance where I'm looking at it and going, I connect with this. I connect with what they're going with. I can feel the passion behind what Key is doing here.
I want to point out something Nari said in Anemoe chat earlier, which also applies to a lot of people here, where he said, this is the first time I've been here for a new announcement since I became a Key fan. And that applies to so many people. So like, we're all just gonna kind of like ride this hype train together until release. Mitsuna, can you read out loud what you just said about 2024, about the release window?
Oh, so usually the Rough Note, which is that book I was talking about earlier, so each year at Comic Market, winter, Key release a key set, there's the new calendar for that year, some like schedule stickers, and usually a few goods and stuff like a keychain, and sometimes they give out like an Emma, like a New Year's wooden board, and usually an arranged CD. But yeah, there's usually a Rough Note for the next game. And usually, like with Summer Pockets, the Rough Note, I believe, was 2017's one. So the game then came out 2018. Yeah, it usually, because it's key set 2024, it usually relates to the game coming out like for that year, because this is like the key set for that year. This is all the contents of what you should expect in that year. Same with the previous key sets having each kinetic novel's rough note or like notes for that the next year to come, and then the game comes out. I'd assume it's 2024. Unless there's a delay, but I mean the key set is for that year, and that's usually why they put it in the key set.
I would put it out. We are much further along in development than like they were willing to say, because
they're just being vague to not.
They're being vague because the thing is with visual novels, you spend the most time in concepting phase and basically like about a year in finalized writing. So the fact that they've got heroine designs, personalities around these heroines, like core ideas, they've got the core message already down. They've already got like the foundation, so now they're all just like going. The fact that like you have like Nijima Yu going, yeah, I'm just eating pizza toast and writing, like that's final. Yeah. Like they're in the finalized phases, so. I'd say this might actually be the first key work in a while to not get delayed.
Was Summer Pockets delayed? I don't remember.
The original was delayed, yes.
Reflection? By like a couple months.
A month.
Really? I don't remember.
They originally announced it for May, if I remember correctly.
Okay. Yeah, it came out in June, didn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right. I will... Yeah, like most delays are very menial. I mean, Lunaria got delayed like one.
Lunaria did not get delayed. Stella got delayed. It was announced for April, and we got it in September.
Regardless, though, they will still definitely, considering it's key set 2024. It's gonna, and next year's 25th anniversary. So they, it will be, even if it does get a delay, I don't think it would push into 2025. That just doesn't.
No,
they wouldn't be making an announcement stream now. For it to then be that this
2 years down,
we don't even have like an
a full release date. We'll have.
Seeing what we saw today, I've changed my tune. Originally, I predicted early 2025. Now I don't think so anymore. Between with what you said about the rough note and just seeing how much they were willing to show today.
Technically this year's the 25th. Yeah, but Key has always, their anniversary, their first work releasing, they've always counted it from canon.
Which was June of 1999.
Yep. I will say, just one last little bit, because, like I said, this is a very exciting time. What I'm very happy about, overwhelmingly, is I was in the old Key server whenever Summer Pockets got announced, and there was no excitement around Summer Pockets in that server. Like, it fell on deaf ears, because the community there was very much,
He died after Clannad.
It died after Clannad. It was primarily a Clannad server, if I must be honest.
Wow,
and
they didn't
so, so, no, they had, but, like, for most people... Wow. I felt like there just was no hype. I was like the only one super excited. So, yeah, that's not what happens here, and that's what I'm so happy about. With the announcement of a full price work, I am so overwhelmingly proud of the community for just being like so just jazzed about it. Like, I feel like this was my vision for Keyverse from the start, was just getting a community that no matter what, like even if like they're not entirely sold, they're still excited about seeing what Key does, and that makes me happy, especially for because this is the first full price work since Keyverse has been created, and it's very, very exciting.
All right, I think I'm gonna cut it off here if you two are good with that.
Yeah,
fine with me.
Thank you again, Mitsuna, for live translating.
I just want to say thanks, Mitsuna. You're awesome.
No.
I just
want
to jump in. I was waiting for you guys to stop recording. I love y'all. Thank you so much. Good night, everyone.
You too.
All right.